One of the things you brought tonight that I was looking at these while we were putting this together, and this is internet. I can kind of let a few things go. It's an oh shit moment, okay? And you know, this is. Let's talk a little bit about this because you know I'd asked about the budget, asked about what the money's doing, where we're going. So pull up the one slide here and let's go to the charts and let's. Throw a few charts out there at the folks that are watching tonight.
I guess just to backtrack a little bit, what you see, the green line is the historical property tax rate in Hays County. And going back a couple of months, you'll recall that we actually halted a new tax rate increase. And we had probably about 100 people that were involved that came down and participated in that and got the county commissioners to do the right thing. So while we were kind of patting ourselves on the back, nobody was really looking out forward to see what is going to happen to the tax rate in the future. And I went and requested a report from the county auditor, and what you see in the blue line is what they, it's sort of the official, here's what's going to happen to the tax rate in the next few years. Now, the reason...
but it's going to flatten out. Okay.
the reason it jumps up is because we've been taking on a lot of debt in the county.
Yeah.
And you know, as the time goes on, now they won't have to come back. I don't believe the commissioner's court will have to come back and ask for approvals on those property tax rate increases, because when the voters approved the bonds that were issued initially, that is, you know, that's the sort of the approval for the property tax rate increase. But I don't think, I've never heard it.
I don't remember any of that when the advertising was going for the bonds. I mean, some of us talked about it. We knew that. But in general, well, I don't think the public was really keen to what was going on.
Yeah, for the parks bond, if you're going to borrow $30 million, when you hear bond, that means you're going to be paying for it at some point. And so one of the commissioners in particular, who won't be with us any longer, he kept referring to it as a voter-approved self-tax increase. You know, when you increase tax on yourself, and that's essentially what we did. Maybe we didn't realize we were doing it. But if you go back to the screen, that little blue jump up is taking into account some of the parks bonds, some of the road bonds that have been approved before. Now, the red line above that is we've got a new law enforcement center that is being requested by the county and by the sheriff's department. Now, we've got a new sheriff in. I don't know what the status of that's going to be. I know the county jail has had some traditional problems. I also know that they're saying that they're reaching a capacity issue. So, you know, it's like government typically does, I mean, particularly these last few years, we love to build buildings. So the red line that you see is taking into account another $20 million bond package that they, I suppose, hope to present next year to let us vote on for a new county jail. And then the yellow line on top is the $35 million version of that county jail.
All right, which is about, you know, we had the Comal Debt Busters on the show about a month ago, and I know that they're still getting involved over there. I've been seeing it's interesting that they were sending me back our report that we had written, that they had that was really interesting, and that report was about $150,000, but it was money well spent. It was interesting because I think for the most part, they said that, yeah, you can get by with just doing a few things without having to spend that money. And
I think for where we are right now, particularly with all the projects that have been undertaken in the last 5 years that we're just now starting to pay for, and we've got the new county offices, the Taj Mahal going in, and we've got the jail. I sat in on a county emergency services meeting last week. And we're trying to consolidate all the 911 services so that they can do a better job of dispatch, and that makes a lot of sense, but that will likely involve a new building if, you know, you believe the presentation that we saw the other day. So, you know, all of these things are just stacking up on top of each other.
Well, I hope they're talking the old Justice Center over here, you know.
And we've got more Rose bonds that need to be spent. I'm not sure that those are reflected in that number.
Okay.
So we've got all sorts of things, and I'll say that between those lines, somewhere we might consider that sort of the low end of what it might cost us. I'm not sure it's all built into that. We've still got a lot of work to do to figure it out. But.
Well, I think, and the other things you had there, I think on the next slide was where the money's coming from and where it's spent. I think which is also kind of a an eye opener here as well, because you know. Yeah, this is a little bit harder to see for you, but you know, what's the big slice there?
Well, in short, we're we list revenues at about $90 million.
Okay.
And the big slice of it is property tax. You know, two-thirds of it comes from property taxes. And, you know, the next biggest slice, my eyes aren't that good. I think it's going to be the sales tax aspect. But the thing about sales tax in 2011, we don't know what the economy is really going to look like.
Right.
And so that is a variable. And, you know, should it slide down, we need our new county commissioners court and, you know, the returning ones to be in a position where they've thought through all of this, and if the sales tax isn't coming in like they hope, that we've got a backup plan to either make some cuts or hopefully not raise property taxes again.
Yeah. So we're going to have to figure somewhere, you know, that you've got revenue, you've got expenditures. To, you know, we've talked about that before. It's a checkbook. You know,
well,
you've
and, got, you know. And we don't have a lot of balance right now. If you, we got $90 million coming in, and I think if you'll put up the next slide there, we'll show that we've got $243 million going out.
Yeah, these are millions here. We're talking the big bucks, you know.
And if you look at where it's going, that big purple slice is new capital projects.
New capital projects,
so
okay.
Buildings, roads, essentially. And there's some computer equipment and that sort, but that's the small piece. The big part is buildings and roads.
Yeah.
And so I think what's happened is, you know, as always happens in good times, you get into a real amenity culture mindset. You know, we've got tennis courts that never get played on that are lighted all night, and I'm sure that there are a few people that really appreciate that. It's a great amenity for a neighborhood or for a community, but at some point we have to start asking the question, can we really afford this right now?
Yeah.
And I think the economic outlook for the next several years, Ben Bernanke just last week said that he expects unemployment to stay about the same for the next 4 or 5 years. And we're sitting on a real unemployment rate of 20 to 25%. And he typically paints a pretty rosy picture, too. So, you know, I'd say the odds are good that we're not going to see any upticks. We're likely going to see some sliding down in the economy. And still, we've got all these roads, you know, that are planned on being built. We're buying right-of-ways on the corner of the county for roads that, you know, we couldn't possibly need to expand for the next 10 years. And so, yeah, what I'd like to see happen, and I'm working with a few other citizens on this project, is we're working on going through the budget, and we want to put together a budget to take back to the county commissioners and say, you know, from a citizen standpoint, this is what some of us would like to see done, and here's why. And we've got to realize that this is not 2007 any longer, and, you know, times are a lot different. We've got to start rethinking some of the things that a couple of years ago we thought were really important. They're probably not as important today as they were then.
Yeah.
And then we have to figure out, can we afford them?
Well, and that's, you know, that's just basically what so many people have had to go through in the last, you know, 5 to 10 years with, you know, all of a sudden you've got two incomes coming in. You get a pink slip, or you've got one income. You know, you've got to go back down and figure out what is it that you need to maintain,
right,
and what is it you can do without. And, you know, we talk about this with, you know, across the community, that this is what people are dealing with.
Yep.
At a micro level, well, that's also what we're going to have to deal with at the macro level as well, is figuring out what is it that we absolutely need to deal with, what is it that is a good to have later on, and how can we do more with less, with what we have?
That's the question of the day.
Yeah.
And if you look at the $90 million coming in versus the $250 million coming out, well, if we change that back to thousands and say it costs me $90,000 a year to live, but I'm spending $250,000, we know the outcome on that.
Yeah.
And so I don't think we have any real good reason to expect different outcomes.
Now, and that leads into here is spending versus revenue.
That's just the property tax aspect of it. So that's two-thirds of the revenue. But
yeah,
that's a pretty frightening graph. And that came right out of county documents. I didn't mock that one up.
Okay, I want to go back because this is interesting. The last time that we spent, that the property tax was the same as the spending, basically, is it that, you know, we kept this, is I guess we're getting the money from different places and that fills in the gaps.
Yeah.
But is 1986, that's where that graph starts, right?
I believe so.
You know, and here we are going back through those last few dots that go stair climbing up. It looks almost like an Al Gore chart, I think. You know,
the hockey stick, yeah.
Yeah, the hockey stick there. That is 4 years, the last 4 years. And, you know, this is where now we have voted in, we've made a change, we're trying to make that transition, but it's not going to change overnight. People are going to have to realize that, that the newly elected representatives that we have at the county level are going to have to really, it's going to take a lot to bring that hockey stick back down.
I think over the next few months, we're going to find out a lot about what the people of Hays County really care about. And, you know, conversely, we're going to find out what the County Commissioner's Court really cares about, too. I think when we had the new election, it was pretty obvious that people were asking for some sort of change. Our goal through this budget project that we're working on is to get together and really sort through all these numbers and to know these numbers as well as anybody does, or as well as we possibly can. And then beginning in early February, we want to take, you know, our budget recommendations, the rough draft, we want to take it out to the community. And any organization, neighborhood organization, political organization that wants to have us in to talk, we want to go out and share what we found and then get the feedback from them. You know, and if we put together a list of options, you know, here's our recommendation, here's some other options, what do you think? And get the response from them. And if we take this around through the month of January to 15 or 20 different meetings and make the presentation, I think by the time that month is over, we'll have a real good idea of what the people of Hays County are really looking for. And then ideally, we'll take it into the commissioner's court and make the full presentation and then ask for some actions in response to that. So, you know, this is new for most of us in this county. We haven't really, you know, I haven't been through this before. And for most people I'm talking to, it's the first time. But universally, everybody's telling me it's worth doing. We've got to do it because, you know, when you see the hockey sticks and when you see some of the other charts up there, we don't really have much of an option. Either we go through this process and we make it meaningful and we present it meaningfully to the court, or we're just at, you know, the whim of whatever happens.
Well,
and I don't know anybody that feels like they're not paying enough taxes right now.
Yeah, and I don't know. There's a lot of people that want to get involved that don't know how. And I think that's what, you know, we talk of different levels. I talked about Open San Marcos at the San Marcos level. We have people that get involved and go down to city council that are there at, you know, with what we can do at that level. But then you've got the bigger picture that encompasses all of us, which is Hays County. And that's where you've decided to go down. And you can go down every Tuesday. Every Tuesday.
Nine a.m.
And
please come join us Tuesday 9 a.m. at the courthouse. I would love. Right now we've got three or four people that show up on a pretty regular basis. I would love to see 10 people showing up every week. And I know it's difficult. Everybody's got to work. But if you have the time available in your week, 9 to usually about noon. Sometimes they go long, but 9 to noon is a.
Yeah.
If we can get you there for that, we're in better shape than we are now.
Yeah, because I know that there's lots of folks that are out there retired that have the time that if you really want to make a difference, come down, talk to Sam. I'm not going to give you his contact information because I want you to go down there, meet Sam in person, see him out there and talk with him because that's how this is going to happen and that you're going to be able to make a difference. So,
and Rob, I think what's most concerning is that when we talk about the county budget, that's actually the small part of our property tax. You know, if you live in the city of San Marcos or Dripping Springs or Collar Butte, you're paying city taxes too.
Right.
And those, in a lot of cases, are larger than the county taxes.
Yeah.
School districts are actually the big chunk. So the project that we're doing right now at
Hays
County.
It's just a small microcosm, isn't it?
It's a small part, but it's a good process for us to go through. We're going to learn a lot in this process. And if we do it well, hopefully we can take it back out and whoever's, you know, following the San Marcos Consolidated Independent School District or the Hays or any of the other ones, you know, we want to put together a process and a model and a mindset that we can go out and reach out to all of these municipalities and tax gathering entities and have real conversations with them because we haven't really done enough of that.
Well, and I encourage anyone else that is going down to the school districts to get in touch with us. Come on down. Tell us what you're doing, what you've seen. That's what this forum is for. So, Sam, thank you very much for spending the time, and wish you a Merry Christmas
and
a Happy New
Year. And I hope to come back and share a little bit of what we found sometime in January.
Tomorrow, people, how long did you last? nothing to spare.